What's up, guys? Coach Jeremy here with Weiss Tech Hockey, and in this video, we're going to be talking about a concept that I consider to be very important, and it's a new way of thinking about winning races, winning puck battles. So let's go ahead. We're going to jump straight in. I've got the rink pulled up. We're going to talk about this with X's and O's, and then we're also going to jump over, and I've got some live clips that I want to show you as well from the NHLers. So very important concept, though. So if you talk to a group of youngsters and you say, hey, when you're looking, you know, when you're looking to beat another player to the puck, what are you racing to? And you can ask them that. And most of the time they'll say, we're racing to the puck, right? And so, you know, if you took a line and drew a straight line from the player to the puck, this is how most players are thinking about that puck race, right? They're thinking about how can I, you know, and if you think about it this way, then it's nothing more than a foot race, right? Because all it is whichever player's fastest is going to get to that puck first. And I tell them, you know, it's partially true, but what you need to think about this is it's not actually a race to the puck. It's a race to control the lane to the puck. Okay? So, in other words, if I can take away the other player's skating lane, then I can win the race to the puck, even if I'm a slower skater than the player that I'm racing against. So what does it look like to take away the player's lane to the puck? That would mean instead of just going straight to the puck and may the fastest player win, what I look to do here is if I'm the blue player, I'm going to cut inside and try to get my shoulder inside of the other player's shoulder. Basically, I want to jump in front and take away that other player's skating lane. So it'll look something like that. And that's what we're looking to do, okay? And so it's a simple concept, simple way of explaining it, but remind them, it's not about winning the race to the puck. It's about controlling the lane to the puck. It's about winning the race to the lane to the puck, okay? And the same thing goes, so this is what, like a straight foot race to a puck. This would be like a breakaway situation. So in this case, we could assume like the blue player was the offensive player, the white player was the defensive player. And if that blue player gets inside and takes away that skating lane to the puck, then now not only does that the white player, they're behind that player, so they have to get around the blue player to get back into a defensive position. That hopefully that makes sense, and we're going to show you some clips on this and it'll make more sense after the clips. But we can also think about this in terms of both offensively and defensively. So imagine a race, imagine an offensive player. Let's keep blue as the offensive players for now. Okay, so the blue player has the puck on the boards, and the white player, we've got a white defenseman that's defending, okay? And let's just say it's like this. Okay, what's the ultimate goal of this blue player? The ultimate goal of this blue player is he or she wants to get to the net, right? Ideally, we want to get around the defenseman and to the net, okay? So if we draw a straight line, then that lane looks like this, okay? So if the blue player were just going straight to the net, that would be the lane. Okay, now what we've got here is that there's always jostling for position, right? So this defenseman, if I'm a defenseman, I'm thinking I want to control this lane to the net. So I want to make it so that that player has to get around me before he or she has a chance to get to the net. So I'm looking to control that lane. If I'm this blue forward, I'm looking to control that lane, right? So I want to get around that defenseman as quick as possible and then cut back in so that that defenseman can't control my lane to the net, right? So it's, again, it's not a race to the net. It's a race to the lane to the net. It's a battle for control over the lane to the net, right? So if I'm a good defenseman, I'm just gonna follow this lane and let that forward come right to me. Eventually, that forward has to come back to me. Even if they go way wide, even if the forward's route looks like, even if the forward's route looks something like this, I should make it be, give me 1 second, there we go. Even if the forward route looks like this, eventually, if that player wants a scoring opportunity, he or she has to come back to the net, right? So as a defenseman, if I can maintain that lane, and if I, you know, it won't be an exact straight line like this, but it'll be, you know, it'll be something like this where the defenseman's skating backwards and just basically, I'm gonna move that, they were a little bit closer to start, but basically just controlling the route, you know, so that eventually when that player comes back to the defenseman, the gap is managed properly, and that player can come right with them. Now, if that player is too fast for that defenseman and it looks like that defenseman's gonna get beat, no problem. All that defenseman needs to do now is, let me redraw this a little bit. I mean, like I said, I'm gonna put that defenseman a little bit closer. Okay, so let's say that defenseman's backing up, controlling the lane, but that forward was just faster. Well, now all we do is have that pivot, and then again, we're not pivoting and chasing the forward. We're pivoting and cutting off the lane that we know that forward wants to take. We're cutting off the lane to the net. So it's a battle for control over the lanes, and that's, you know, in any race or even battle situation, that's what we're looking at. We're looking to control the lanes to the route, to either the net or to the puck, right? So let's go ahead now. I've got some game clips from recent games. We're gonna pull those up, and I wanna show you some examples of this in action. Okay, so this first one is a clip from Washington and Buffalo, and this was back in December of 2018. And you know what, this was a phenomenal pass, and everybody's focused in on the pass. You know, I'm sure you may have seen this clip. It was kind of going around the internet and things. It was an alley-oop pass from number 26 here. So let's go ahead and see, he flips it up and over. And like everybody's going crazy over the pass. But the thing that I noticed is this race to the puck. So watch what happens. We're gonna see it from a couple different angles here. But watch what this looks like here. Okay, so the puck lands here. We've got the white player who's actually closer to the puck, the red player, so the Capitals, we got the Buffalo player here, the Capitals player here, and the Capitals player actually has a longer route to the puck because the puck landed more to the right. So the puck kind of landed right in front of the Buffalo player here. But what happens here is watch the route. So this is actually a replay, exact replay of that first example we talked about where it's a neutral zone race. Watch the route that this red player takes. Watch the route that the Washington player takes. He cuts right inside, picks up the puck, and then you know this player has nowhere to go because he got his skating lane taken away. So watch here. Cut right inside, pick up the puck. Now he gets wide and there's nothing that number 55 could do on that. We're gonna see it again from another angle here. So again, keeping in mind, it's not a race to the puck. It's not a foot race here. It's a race to that lane. It's a race to control the lane. So again, we got a fantastic pass. No problem, that's awesome and everything. Okay, but if we pause it here, you can see like they start off side by side. But the difference here is the Capitals player took a better route to the puck. See that? So from here you can see that puck lands right in front of the Buffalo player, but he lets his lane get taken away by the Caps player. Right there. And once you've let your lane get taken away from you, it's really, really hard to get back in a position to maybe, you know, make a play on that. Okay, once again, they both have the same starting point here, okay? And really it boils down to a smarter route. Take it away. See, now, because he took away that skating lane, the Buffalo player is stuck behind him. And he's keeping that puck out in front. He gets low and wide, okay? There's just not much that can be done to defend against that. So fantastic play there. That's the first one. Let's go ahead and jump over to the next one here. All right, so this next one's Boston versus Toronto. This is from January of 2019. And here's a great example of Nylander racing to the net and controlling the lane to the net. So watch this. We see Nylander picks it up here. Okay, now he drives it wide. Now watch what he does. He's not just gonna, so a lot of times, especially with the youngsters, when they feel like this pressure here, they kind of just, you know, this guy's here, he's maintaining that lane, and they kind of just let themselves drift off to the side and maybe take a bad angle shot from here or whatever. Nylander doesn't do that. He jumps and drives through right into the front of the Boston player here and then controls the lane to the net. Now, this other guy ends up making the stop on this, but what I'm looking at here is this. It's not a race to the net. It's a race to the lane to the net. It's a battle for control over the lane to the net. And in this case, Nylander wins that battle here. So let's go ahead and watch this. See that? He takes away the Boston player's skating lane. And now what's happened here, it's the same concept. The Boston player has nothing. He's stuck behind him now. And the only thing he can try to do is kind of reach, but Nylander's got good body positioning, good puck protection there, and it can't happen. Okay, now, like I said, this guy comes over and ends up saving the day, or else it would have been a much more threatening situation. Okay, but that's a really nice example of puck protection and owning the lane to the net. You know, he doesn't settle for a bad angle shot from the wide side. He drives right through owns the lane to the net and gets himself there. And this next one's an example of defensively, you know, kind of the same idea. So now this time Boston has the puck, and the Leafs defenseman does a really nice job. Now, Boston ends up scoring on this, but the Leafs defenseman on the initial play does a great job of, again, controlling the lane to the net, anticipating where that Boston player wants to go, and then controlling the lane to the net. I think it's Zaitsev on this. So let's go ahead and watch this. Okay, number 22 on Toronto here. So you can see it's the same idea, but he's controlling. He's got himself positioned where... you know, if the Boston player wants to come back to him, he's got to come straight through Zaitsev here. Okay, when the Boston player hits the brakes, then that's, for me, that's a cue to close down. So as soon as they hit the brakes, turn their back on you, that's when you collapse on them. And Zaitsev does that. But the problem is we didn't have other players in support positions here. So the Leafs are slow on the back check, didn't pick up the guy coming in the high slot here. But what I'm looking at right there, so it was a nice goal and everything, but what I was looking at is, again, 22 on the Leafs. And let's watch that one more time, and I won't pause it this time. We'll just kind of run through it here, slow motion. But watch how he controls the lane to the net. The ideal, you know, what the attacker wanted to do is, you know, get around him and drive to the net. But Zaitsev forced him to have to make another option. And of course, it worked out in Boston's favor in this case, because we didn't have proper support from you know, from the back checkers on Toronto's side of things. But those are three really good examples in my mind of you know, controlling lanes to the puck and to the net. So take that, think about it, show it to your players if you think it'll help. And we'll be back again soon with you know, with more drills, skills, and everything else. If you're looking for more stuff like this, go to WeissTechHockey.com. We've got tons of stuff there on the website, and all kinds of good stuff that'll help you with your coaching.